is for you now.
He's Hollywood now.
He forgot us.
Three, two,
okay,
one,
let's get started. Toffee versus Deathspade. Speaking of characters, I mentioned this earlier. Toffee's Palutena was something he just recently came out with to deal with Pluto's Game & Watch. So we'll see how it fares against Deathspade's Game & Watch killer.
Fair? Is that a spoiler, Jim?
Did I say fair?
Yeah, like
yes,
fair.
It was.
Yeah, like, I think. That's all I needed. Just like Toffee only needed that side B to kind of connect. That's the first stock of our winner's final.
Yeah, cleanly. Toffee's dealt with this with Sora.
But that has to hurt. It doesn't take the stock, but getting an F smash beat never feels good.
Yeah. And then that Nair clipping the teleport recovery right back to stage. This is some familiarity with each other that we're seeing on screen.
Yes, but that familiarity, a blessing or a curse, because you know Toffee has your number in certain scenarios.
Second F smash call out, and then a taunt at ledge. And that big start.
Big pickup from Deathspade there.
The set has swung both ways now.
Yes, indeed. It is going back and forth. This is what we'd love to see. I mean, these two always have kind of a back and forth in the games, at least. So I expect nothing different. This is a pretty big stage, $1,000 pop. So there's a lot of money on the line.
Okay. Yeah. You know, Smash players definitely don't fight for the money.
But if it's there.
It's a little more motivation and a little more pressure.
Yeah, because they're not goofing around like it's battle phase, you know? This is the big boss here.
I was talking with Deathspade just the other day about fighting these high-level players for $10, $20.
Yeah.
It's a little more on the line here. Toffee maintaining his lead against Deathspade.
Yeah, just hanging on to this stock, kind of giving Deathspade quite the trouble to find it here.
For the double attempt on the downer. Falling out of the Sora up here.
I was kind of peeping Floopy just in case, but if this is the set, Floopy's already up. Yeah. But anyways, if you guys want to watch it, I'm in the side stream. Us here, we got quite the slobber non-grad. Deathspade has even out the stocks, but you know, Toffee just sitting pretty.
And outpacing that fireball just enough.
Yep. Tries to line up the down air. I mean, Toffee, infamous for, you know, the amount of spikes he goes for, he lands. Just honestly, his edge guarding is just a trademark of a Toffee placement. Maze!
Oh, a little ladder.
Up and away, indeed. That game was just grabbed from the clutches of Toffee. It was for sure his game to lose.
Yeah.
And Deathspade found that nair and just knew exactly what to do.
Gotta be very aware of the absurd things Sora can get off of all of his stray aerials. And we see in the swap to a little more familiar territory.
This, of all the matchups that these two have played, is probably one of the rarer ones for sure. Usually when Deathspade's feeling Sora, Toffee's on like the Mega Man, or maybe even the Diddy Kong.
I haven't seen the Diddy Kong in a while. That would be a treat.
That's a throwback for sure. But honestly, Mario's a throwback. I feel like I haven't seen Toffee use this character in a long time.
No, it's been a lot of Mega Man and Palutena recently. It's like a steady combo for him.
Yes, but obviously Mario can always fill that niche of being, this is the character I used to dominate you youngins with way back in the day.
Yeah. Listen, I haven't forgotten my old tricks.
Yeah, I mean, Toffee was, you know, a dominant number one in our scene for
African, nasty, brutish, ugly fellow.
Smelly. But right now, Nesme kind of trying to put it back into its resting coffin here.
Ooh.
Immediately countering right out of the combo. Jeez. Oh my goodness. Toffee was a man on a mission, and it was not completed.
No words. That is something.
Okay. A big reset there from Deathspade. Gonna continue this edge guard open. Toffee just slips by.
What do you got, Toffee? What did you do? Body was sick of the upper parts. Yeah.
Temple's just giving me a posture check. That's what I got. It wasn't anything bad.
It's important. It's important to stretch, Chad. Start now.
Yeah.
Anyway, back to the match.
Yeah.
Deathspade?
Freaking death upon Spades. I was gonna say something a lot more poetic, but I was like,
yeah.
Let's just cash out today. I don't want to get too much.
Sometimes you start a joke and you figure you're smart enough to find a punchline later.
Yeah.
But, Toffee
he needs to find the stock now. Because, future Toffee can't deal with that. Especially Toffee is no longer on the screen.
And putting Deathspade up 2-0.
Yeah, the OG for sure. And I mean, we saw the same song and dance with the other number one in KC, or all but number one in KC, Floopy. You know, Deathspade doing a little pop-up in the first game, but just taking that
Mega Man.
A full 3-0 and a handshake.
Yep. And once again, we've got yet another character swap from Toffee here. Putting on what you had predicted earlier, the Mega Man suit.
Yes. Donning the super fighting robots. And, boy, Mega Man, he can put in some work, but that's made all too accustomed to all those tricks.
Deathspade Sora must have leveled up recently or something.
He thought he lost Ghost or something.
Came in and yelled Toffee. He's busy.
He's busy right now.
That's funny.
Maybe not much longer. I mean, it's kind of insane that, you know, Deathspade Sora has kind of returned to form in a big way.
Yeah. But, Toffee's Mega Man never fell out.
Yeah.
Ooh, little pellet to get a little extra damage on Sora.
Yeah, that's how you know Toffee's in the post. When he starts popping the melons, that's whatever.
That's gonna be it.
It's funny seeing Mega Man just do a big ol' hop, even though he's nowhere near the ledge. He puts so much effort.
Yeah. Rush falls down to precipitate his doom.
Yeah. Okay, tricky recovery path, because you know that hard knuckle would've came down and sent your stock packet.
Yeah, there's bears to avoid and bears to avoid, and Sora had the tools to get past all of it.
Yep. Catch out fair 1, 2, 3.
Deathspade reclaiming the lead and making this look a little more like the past two games.
Yeah, just playing fundamental here, not really going for those big combos or, you know, like that one that ended game one. Just, you know, throwing out spells, getting the fair 1, 2, 3, and catching out.
You know, there's something to be said for Deathspade frequently doing the best in Kansas City at these pretty large tournaments.
Yeah.
You know? He was the highest placer at Sweet Spot just recently.
Mm-hmm. Cherry tree. wasn't at Russell, so can't really talk about that space.
But you know, I think we're all back to something like Rewired 2. Deathspade, when he's competing in the Midwest,
unmatched. Yeah. At least for KC standards.
For KC standards, does very, very well. To prove that pattern right.
Okay, that's a big pickup from Deathspade. Once again, we saw that combo kind of be one of the few to put Toffee stocks away in the previous games, but that's a big chin check.
Yeah, yeah. And a little bit in. Nope. Deathspade comes out of that combo swinging.
Yeah. And that's what you like to see, you know, Deathspade not getting disheartened after getting just freaking obliterated by Uphill. Yeah. Kind of keep going.
It's nothing he hasn't seen before.
Yep.
It's nothing he hasn't beat before.
Good thing Thunder does not work.
Well, back air reversal from Toffee, and suddenly Deathspade's on the ropes.
Oh my goodness. This is that punish, and the same combo. Gonna cap it off with an upbe this time, and actually not enough damage. Let's take it. Oh, but that is nice.
Deathspade shutting down his win. Dragon Demons 3-0 each to secure his prestige spot in Grand Finals.
Yeah.